this old machine that I've been using as my wood lathe has a sliding spindle screw cutting mechanism. I'm going to sell this lathe, but before I do so, I want to try and cut some thread with it. I've loosened up the bolts that mount the motor to the bench, because when the spindle moves forward, it tightens up the belt, and this way the motor is allowed to move a little. I'm using a bungee cord to pull the motor back. This lathe came with 6 thread templates or masters. 6 and 1 star nut with 6 positions. And this is for 8, 12, 16, 20, 28 and 36 TPI. And I think it's Woodward, so that's not very useful in a metric world. To engage the threading mechanism, you loosen up this nut and the nut on the other side. Then you pull up the lever and lock the nuts again. Now the female thread is interlocked with the male thread and the spindle moves forward when turning. If you saw my previous video, you know that this lathe is no good when it comes to cutting metal. So I am going to cut some thread into this piece of wood that came from a rowan tree. I don't know what the threadability of a rowan tree is, but I guess I'm going to find out. Scheiße. You need one good catch at least. There it is, the amazing mallet. The fact that the belt slips so easy is not a good sign. I might need to install a second bungee cord. That should fit. I just realized you can't turn between centers with the spindle sliding forward. That doesn't work. So I have a test piece mounted on the faceplate, but it is now running hopelessly out of round. So I'm going to try and screw it up using this scraper made from a file on the cross slide. A bit of lubrication. I'm ready to start cutting. I have the frequency drive and local control, so I can easily reverse the spindle. I'm not sure if this motor is strong enough, but here we go. It's a bit of a rough cut. Maybe I should put some oil on there. If I reverse it too much, it locks up. Need more power. that last cut took almost all the thread off. Well, that was a total failure. Let's try it again with some glue. This here is for wood rod repair. I'm not sure how effective this stuff is on wet wood, but I will speed up the drying with a heat gun. It's the next day and the glue is dry, so I'm ready to continue. Here we go. This is going nowhere. Well, I wasn't expecting much. Well, that's a mess. Well, gluing the wood didn't help. I guess I need a different kind of wood, but I wouldn't know about wood. So this is a piece of pine or fir. I always get those two mixed up. I'm not sure if there is any difference, but this is a totally dry. The other wood that was pretty wet. Maybe I should spray a little WD-40 on there. That probably helps a lot. The WD-40 seems to have soaked in nicely. So it's time to cut some thread. This is gonna be great. Maybe not. I'm quitting this experiment. It's not possible to thread wood.
The next night I dreamt up a few more cool tests I could try out. So let's do some more wood threading. Using the old sliding spindle lathe.
For this test I will be using a different tool bit. This one has a bit of a positive rake and it is not as sharp. Well, at least the point is not as sharp. It has a bigger radius on there. Alright, this is a piece of Meranti wood. Good for making window frames. One more cut. It doesn't look good. So Meranti is no good. This is a piece of beech and it's still wet. I was going to try this piece of tropical hardwood, but it disintegrates when turning. Big chunks fly off. And this is a piece of water soaked and frozen Meranti. It's running a bit out of round. I don't think I can take more off. This is starting to look like a thread. I trued this up, so let's try again. Whoa! I'm thinking I might be onto something here. With a little bit of practice, I might actually be able to cut some thread.